Hey ladies and gentlemen, Steven here from Redolescents. Welcome back to another video. Today we're going to be taking a closer look at a fragrance by the company Dossier. Now you know Dossier makes inspirations or clones of more popular designer and niche fragrances. Here we have one called Woody Chestnut. You can probably tell what it is because there's another fragrance containing the note of chestnut that has amassed a really strong reputation. And of course, that fragrance is called By the Fireplace by Maison Martin Margiela. I'm going to be letting you know my thoughts on this fragrance, how close I think it comes to the original. So make sure to stay tuned. Before I begin my review of Woody Chestnut by Dossier and I tell you all about this fragrance, what I think it smells like, how close it comes to the original, the performance, so on and so forth, I do want to mention that if you are a fan of fragrance related content, if you like fragrance reviews here on YouTube, but also top 10 videos, giveaways, unboxings, and more, please do consider supporting this channel by subscribing to it. And of course, if you can give this video a thumbs up, it would really, really mean a lot to me. So here we have a company that has a pretty cool service in place, which is where when you do purchase the fragrance, and in the case of this one, it's only $29, so you really can't go wrong there for a 50 ml, you also receive this sample. Now, what happens is you can actually wear this entire sample, and if you're done wearing it, maybe perhaps you're not that big a fan of the fragrance, you didn't like it as much as you thought you were going to, you can actually return the 50 ml bottle, get a full refund, no questions asked, which I think it's pretty cool. And so I do like that they have this service where you can kind of commit to purchasing a bottle without really feeling like you're in the negative 30, 40, 50 bucks, what have you. But in the case of this one, this does go for $29. And so this is called Woody Chestnut. And of course, this is their inspiration of By the Fireplace by Maison Martin Margiela, a fragrance that I personally love. Warm, sweet, nutty, vanillic, ambery, a touch of smoke in the base. I'm going to be letting you know how close I think this one comes to the original. Let's start things off with the presentation. Of course, on the inside of the box, you do have this card with the presentation. You also have the note breakdown on the back, along with the concentration and a few other tidbits of information. So the concentration for this one is actually a bit stronger than some of the other Dossier fragrances that I own. It's 18%, which is in the vein of a note de parfum. And the notes are as follows. In the top, you have pink pepper, orange blossom, and cloves. In the mid, you have chestnut, guaiacwood, and cade wood. And I know cade oil comes across quite smoky, and I'm guessing that that's partly responsible for that smoke accord that you're going to get in the base of this one. And then in the base, of course, we have vanilla, Peru balsam, and cedarwood. So right in the opening, I guess you get just a touch of the orange blossom, kind of giving it this flavorful introduction, a little bit into that citrusy territory, but it's so short-lived. And immediately you have this cade, vanilla, balsamic richness that kind of comes together and really fuses to create the base and heart of the composition. Now, I know in the heart I mentioned there's chestnut, guaiacwood, and cade, and so you have a couple of ingredients from the heart. I'm not really getting too much of the guaiacwood because there are some other fragrances like Guaiac 10 by Le Labo, and it has a very specific smell. I'm not getting a whole lot of that from this perfume. And then in the base, namely, you're going to get the vanilla, and I almost kind of get like a little bit of like a patchouli vibe. I know it's not listed as a note. Maybe it is for the original. For this one, it's not listed, but I'm getting a little bit of that earthiness, and I feel like the cade, maybe a little birch tar, which is not listed in the note breakdown, kind of comprises that smoky vibe that you're gonna get. But it's not that heavy of a smoky vibe that it overshadows the vanilla and the chestnut and some of these other really warm, sensual, mysterious, and gourmand ingredients. And it also gives off a vibe that is cozy. And I think if I were to select one adjective that I think perfectly describes this fragrance, it would definitely be cozy. I think there's something very warm, rich, and cozy about this one, where if you're snuggled up on the couch with a significant other, maybe you're reading a book, you have the fireplace on, you're watching a movie, maybe you're watching some Netflix, This is the type of fragrance that I can see myself enjoying in the heart of autumn and winter when the weather gets a little bit colder outside. And so I've actually had this bottle for a few months now. I specifically waited until it got a little bit colder outside. I know we're still kind of in the summer. The last day of summer is September 22nd, but I think now would be a good time to start picking up some of these colder driven fragrances so that you can enjoy them when the colder fragrance rolls around. And so vanilla, that Peru balsam gives it that balsamic rich sweetness that I really, really love. A little bit of earthiness, like I mentioned, a touch of patchouli, which is not listed in the note breakdown. And the chestnut just gives it that quirky, different angle that I think is so enjoyable. And it's the one element that really makes this stand out. And so how close do I think this comes to the original? Like 95%, if I'm being honest. I do find that this comes very, very close to the original. And personally, I have smelled the original on a number of occasions. I love the way that it smells. There were a few others like Beach Walk that I wasn't really crazy about. And kind of a few others where I thought that they smelled great, but I really couldn't find the occasion to wear them in. In the case of this one, I can see myself wearing this on a regular basis, along with their inspiration of Rose 31, Santal 33. I actually own a couple from the brand. I'm pointing to them like you can see them off camera here, but I do own a few from the brand, and this one is solid. 95% like the original, smoke, vanilla, earthiness, cade, touch of cedar wood, a little bit of that orange blossom in the opening. Pink pepper gives off a rosy vibe. Don't really get anything rosy in this fragrance, but a solid release, one that I'm definitely looking forward to wearing in the autumn. Let's go ahead and finish things off with my overall assessment. So first up, in terms of the uniqueness and the overall smell, of course, this is not a unique perfume because it is a clone of a more popular designer fragrance by Maison Martin Margiela called By the Fireplace, and this one comes 95% close. I personally love the smell. However, if you are somebody who is into the brighter, fresher, more citrusy and aquatic fragrances, this one requires a bit more of an acquired taste. And so definitely try it before you buy it, which is the service that they do offer with the sample. And I think that that will sort of help you gauge and make up your mind as to whether or not you can see yourself wearing this in the long run. In terms of the longevity, you can expect about 8 hours on your skin. The projection was great for the first 2 hours of application. Never really radiated beyond an arm's length, maybe in the first 20 minutes or so, but it didn't start to sit closer to the skin until about that 5.5 hour mark. In terms of the versatility, I don't see myself wearing this one in the hotter weather. I think it's perfectly unisex, although some people would argue that the woodsy elements like the cedar wood, the guaiac wood, the cade, which is a little bit smoky, that might lean a little bit masculine, but in my opinion, it's unisex. I think it can be worn casually because, like I stated earlier, there's a certain scenario where you're sitting on the couch, you're enjoying maybe a glass of Cabernet, or you have the fireplace lit, you're watching a movie with your loved one. That's casual, right? That's very cozy, staying at home. But I can also see this one working really well in a formal environment, especially if you're going to be subjected to some colder temperatures. So I find it to be a pretty versatile fragrance. I just wouldn't wear it in the hotter weather. I think it could be a little bit too cloying, a little overkill. And in terms of the presentation is rather simplistic. In terms of the box, it has a little bit of that Le Labo aesthetic, but I do like the presentation and the simplicity, I think, also helps to keep the price down. So my final verdict on this fragrance is, if you are a fan of By the Fireplace by Maison Martin Margiela, and you're looking for something that performs really well, it comes 95% close to the original, 18% concentration of aromatic compounds, and you have $29 burning a hole in your pocket, by all means, please check this one out. And guess what? If you don't like it, you can just return it, no questions asked. And I love that that have that policy instituted within the brand so that it gives you the opportunity to sample the fragrance without feeling like you're really married to the offer, right? You can always get that refund if you so wish. So there you have it, ladies and gents. Thank you so much for joining me today. I really hope you took something of value from this video. I really enjoyed this fragrance, but I'm also a fan of the original, and hopefully I'll get around to reviewing it for the autumn now that the weather is going to be getting cold within the next month or two. If you did take something of value from this review, I would really appreciate it if you would consider supporting this channel by subscribing to it. Again, don't forget to give this video a thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm. Thanks again for watching. Love you guys. We'll see you soon. Bye.